in rookie scoring. It's his first game against Toronto. Matthews sends it rink wide. On the move is William Nylander. From an angle, he'll test Martin Jones. Ranked second last in the league in face-off efficiency. But here's Beniers at center. Matthews comes back to take it away. He had a hat trick against the Kraken last year. Great pass ahead to Nylander. Over the line, Riley butted with a shot that went off the blocker high, and a rebound chance for Nylander as the Leafs come close.
Takes off, so he jumps up in the play, creates the odd man rush, and there's the quick little release by Bunting trying to go block.
He's had since suffering his knee injury.
Yeah, just over 19 and then just over 20 in the other two.
Here's Engvall right in, and that's off the logo of Jones.
Nice job of Nylander getting the rebound. I like the fact that
here's Tavares, and it slipped off his stick with Marner driving the net. Back to Hall and across for Giordano. His shot, that Marner looked for the tip in front. Got it to Tavares. Willigren, nice pass. Engvall on the move again. Two on one with Holmberg. And across for Holmberg, and the pass disrupted. Following up, Aston Reese. Stopped on the short side. Off a stick, and Oleksiak, a hit for Eberle. And stepping in front of that pass was Giordano. He'll center it. Unable to redirect that. 498 career points. Another slick move. Shot knocked down in front. Centering pass, and that doesn't reach Tavares. And
with that quick spin out of the corner.
Here's Sandin off that face-off win. Got a shot, moved up to play it for Kerfoot. Looks like the Leafs have been ready for that speed tonight. Holmberg's in! Holmberg flipped the back in off the shoulder, I believe, of Jones.
How do you counteract that? Good quick passes to catch them on their aggressiveness. That's what happened. That's what, about the third odd man rush that the Leafs have had. Holmberg trying desperately to stay onside. And
up to Yarncroke, looking for Tavares. That pass broke it up. Marner nearly stole it at center. McCann got it back. Comes across for Larson. Adam Larson back to Dunn. Fired that across. Can't have it. Able to knock that down. There's the first shot. And a chance for Sprong. Here's a battle won by Oleksiak. He'll drop it off. And Beniers over skates and a breakaway for William Nylander in. And a backhand stop by Jones. Centered it and knocked out of midair. Wide of the net by Yarncroke.
This little drop to all of a sudden, okay, I've got a lane to the net. Does a good job of keeping his legs going, but there at the last second, there's Schultz that just forced him to tuck the puck over, a little back. And also the respect factor of just the tough job that they have.
Leafs start the second period on the power play. Couple dozen seconds, and away goes Nylander. He had three shots in the period. Chance for Brody, stop! Loose in front, and Matthews got a stick on it, couldn't get it to the net.
He's going to his backhand, slid across and got down, and the one guy on the ice probably unsuspecting of getting the good chance.
McCann cruising down the left flank, sent around by Bjorkstrand. Bjorkstrand will play it back in the direction of McCann. At the line, it's Vince Dunn, and a one-time shot scores! It's a power play goal, and the Kraken have the icebreaker, and Ilya Tolvanen has his second power play goal from the exact same spot for Seattle since joining the Kraken.
He's at a point in every game, but this is one that Matt Murray's got to have. I got to see if this deflected at all off Giordano. Yeah, a little bit of a deflection off his pad. Watch the leg of Giordano as this, just enough to make that wobble. Murray thought it was going to come into his body, and there's a lone fan.
Just over a minute left in the double minor. Here's Austin Matthews. Back for Marner. In front, deflected, scores! John Tavares with the redirected puck! The captain's got goal 407.
An old veteran player, he always used to say, you don't have a chance, waste one early high on the goaltender. That one hit Jones right between the eyes. This one, he never even saw. What a great play by Marner. Once again, all Marner's trying to do is make sure he gets it around where the pressure is. You've got that double screen where up high you've got Tavares down below. It's bunting, and Jones puts his hands in the air. He never saw that one, didn't get the five-hole close.
So the Leafs get even. John Tavares has his 16th of the year, and Mitch Marner with point number 499. But back comes Vince Dunn, scores! Off Murray and in, and that didn't take long. 14 seconds later.
Well, here's another trend that you're not going to like if you're Sheldon Keefe. Look it in front as Dunn just makes sure he gets it through off the arm, and it just trickles by.
Wonder if they'll get some specialists in for that kind of competition.
You know there's going to be so many really, really star players that aren't going to get a chance to be playing in the All-Star game.
Look out, Jerick McCann, get alone, scores! And there's another for Seattle in the second period, and a two-goal lead.
Wow, what a pass by Schwartz here. Impressive play down the wall, and this is just a quick little peek. Morgan Rielly was pinching down. Giordano on the other side was late, and just off to the races came McCann, and he doesn't make mistakes in there. Look at his reaction. He scored his first goal in four, the last game in Edmonton.
16 games with the assist on the Tavares goal for Marner. And he's out there with Nylander and Matthews in the slot. And a glove stop by Martin Jones, maybe his best.
An extra second or two. Nylander off the turnover. You can see on the back foot, so you got to gather.
Jordan Eberle back to Burakovsky. Up against Holmberg. In the slot, Eberle didn't get much on it. Beneer scores. He got plenty on that. And it's 4-1 Seattle.
And just like that, there's the momentum swing that just changes the game. You know, think back to the power play and the Tavares goal. Looked like everything was settled back. He has been able to do this numerous times this year. There's a turnaround. But I think Murray's got to have that one, too, as he just gets lost. Beniers gets away from the traffic. A quick little spin around as Giordano unable to get there to get the block. And that goes underneath the blocker.
Winning some games on the road as compared to last year, but they score goals. They seem to get their offense going and find a way.
Here's Matthews to steal a backhand right on. Rebound reaching forth. Unable to come up with that.
Well, they've won 10 road games already. 10-4-2 is their record, and they're for real. So this is a time to take note.
As it comes back to the line for Sandin. Nylander flipped it in front, fronted by Oleksiak. And out comes Yanni Gord. Here's Gord working in front, and they score. Bjorkstrand on the feed from Gord, and it's a 5-1 Seattle lead.
Oh, there's an example of just taking advantage of the aggressiveness. Down by three, you know you're going to get in and try to attack. Now coming back, Gord gets this pass across. It goes off the blocker on the right side of Murray as he's sliding across. Murray kind of gets caught halfway as it's coming back and then off the inside and in.
And it's Wennberg with the goal. Camp whipped it across. Here's Sandin looking for Hunt at the side of the net. Dryden Hunt trying to jam it in, and Martin Jones going to hold on to that with 3.6 remaining. So this will be the 11th road win for Seattle. It matches their total for all of last year. Four goals in the second, and they win by four. It's a 5-1 Kraken victory here at Scotiabank tonight.